Jared Leto opens up about playing iconic Batman villain the Joker in next summer's highly anticipated Suicide Squad movie. Ever since we learned that musician/Academy Award winner Jared Leto would be playing the Joker in DC's supervillain team-up movie Suicide Squad, the 30 Seconds to Mars frontman has been pretty quiet about taking on the role, but that is slowly changing as production on the film is set to begin in just a couple of months. In an upcoming cover story for Billboard magazine, Leto revealed that the role will require him to gain, quote, a lot of weight, which he is doing by eating every couple of hours. Something Leto says he's terrible at, but we all know he's a very dedicated actor. Now, when asked what inspired him to take on such an iconic role and to do the difficult task of following Heath Ledger's Oscar-winning portrayal of the character in 2008's The Dark Knight, Leto explained that it was the increasing complexity of the genre that ultimately led Suicide Squad to be his first starring role since winning the Best Supporting Actor Oscar last year. He said, quote, "The opportunity to take on this nearly Shakespearean character, that's what graphic novels and comic books are becoming, right? Joker's this beautiful disaster of a character, what a big challenge." I love that description, by the way. In addition to Leto, Suicide Squad is also set to star Will Smith as the eagle-eyed assassin Deadshot and Margot Robbie as Joker's mentally unstable girlfriend Harley Quinn. In fact, while Will and Margot were recently promoting their upcoming film Focus, the pair revealed their inspiration for signing on to the film. Smith told MTV that he looks forward to becoming the, quote, biggest historical image of Deadshot, you know, since the character has yet to appear on the big screen and isn't well known among a majority of moviegoers. And for Robbie, she says she's really looking forward to playing her character in multiple movies, calling Harley rad after all the research she's been doing. Suicide Squad is set to arrive in theaters on August 5th, 2016, and it also stars Jay Courtney as Boomerang, Cara Delevingne as Enchantress, and Viola Davis as Amanda Waller. RoboCop actor Joel Kinnaman is rumored to be taking over the role of Rick Flagg for the recently exited Tom Hardy, plus Hostel's Jay Hernandez is reportedly in talks to play El Diablo. So guys, what do you think of Jared Leto playing the Joker in Suicide Squad? Will he be able to step out of the shadow of Jack Nicholson and Heath Ledger and make the character his own? I think he will be able to. He's very talented. So share your thoughts in the comment section, or you can tweet us, that's at Clever Movies. I'd love to hear what you think about this. I'm at Dana Ward Online. And then when you're done with that, click over here to find out what 7 things we think need to happen in this movie. Until next time, I'm Dana Ward. Thanks for watching Clever Movies, and I hope you have an awesome weekend. And for more Joker chaos, click left to watch him take on Lex Luthor on Fanboy Face Off, or click right to find out which live-action DC movies we think are the best so far. Jared Leto opens up about playing iconic Batman villain the Joker in next summer's highly anticipated Suicide Squad movie. Ever since we learned that musician/Academy Award winner Jared Leto would be playing the Joker in DC's supervillain team-up movie Suicide Squad, the 30 Seconds to Mars frontman has been pretty quiet about taking on the role, but that is slowly changing as production on the film is set to begin in just a couple of months. In an upcoming cover story for Billboard magazine, Leto revealed that the role will require him to gain, quote, a lot of weight, which he is doing by eating every couple of hours. Something Leto says he's terrible at, but we all know he's a very dedicated actor. Now, when asked what inspired him to take on such an iconic role and to do the difficult task of following Heath Ledger's Oscar-winning portrayal of the character in 2008's The Dark Knight, Leto explained that it was the increasing complexity of the genre that ultimately led Suicide Squad to be his first starring role since winning the Best Supporting Actor Oscar last year. He said, quote, "The opportunity to take on this nearly Shakespearean character, that's what graphic novels and comic books are becoming, right? Joker's this beautiful disaster of a character, what a big challenge." I love that description, by the way. In addition to Leto, Suicide Squad is also set to star Will Smith as the eagle-eyed assassin Deadshot and Margot Robbie as Joker's mentally unstable girlfriend Harley Quinn. In fact, while Will and Margot were recently promoting their upcoming film Focus, the pair revealed their inspiration for signing on to the film. Smith told MTV that he looks forward to becoming the, quote, biggest historical image of Deadshot, you know, since the character has yet to appear on the big screen and isn't well known among a majority of moviegoers. And for Robbie, she says she's really looking forward to playing her character in multiple movies, calling Harley rad after all the research she's been doing. Suicide Squad is set to arrive in theaters on August 5th, 2016, and it also stars Jay Courtney as Boomerang, Cara Delevingne as Enchantress, and Viola Davis as Amanda Waller. RoboCop actor Joel Kinnaman is rumored to be taking over the role of Rick Flagg for the recently exited Tom Hardy.